How to use Blenderkit. So first of all, you are opening the website blenderkit.com here. Then you will click the button download Blenderkit. Here will appear the button download. So you're clicking on the download and the add-on is downloaded. So I will close this because I don't need it. Okay. So then you will navigate where your Blenderkit has been downloaded. In my case, this is on desktop and here. So you can see this is the zip file which has been downloaded into your computer. Our next step is to open Blender. I have the last version. Then we are clicking on the edit in the top menu. Then click on the preferences. And here you will see the section add-ons. Click on the button install. And then navigate to the folder where you have just downloaded the Blenderkit. So it is here. I'm clicking one time on the Blenderkit 3.1.0 and I click the button install add-on. It will be installed. It may take some time. Then here it will appear into the library with the add-ons. So if you will open this, if you will press on the arrow, it will be opened, and just mark the checkbox here to activate the add-on. Again, it may take some time. Done, this is done. So simply click the button OK. And the window will be closed. So now I will close this window also. And here you can see that already has appeared with the line with the available assets. So what you can do here, you can click on this button, the categories, and you will be able to see the categories and what exactly those categories are including. So here is the architecture, the characters, and so on and so on and so on. So you can see what exactly is available. Also, you can see the arrows here. So if I will click on the arrows, I will scroll this list from side to side. At this moment, if you will take a look here on the website, so you will be able to see, I'm going back to the main page, here. So at this moment, the Blenderkit is including more than 8,000 of the free models, materials, and HDRs. So all of them will be available here and you will be able to use them as you want. Then how to use them? So for example, how to export them from the Blender into the game clip maker. So I'll remove this cube as we don't need it. I'll click here on the collections and then I will select, for example, this telephone. So I'm clicking on it once and as you can see, the telephone has appeared here on the scene. Then on the right side, I will click on it again here, the telephone booth. Like this. After that, I'm clicking on the button File, Export, AFBX. Then navigate to the folder with the game, Clipmaker, Streaming Assets, Your Content, Objects, and I will save my FBX file here. Type the name, I will name it Telephone. And now very important settings. So here on the right side, as you can see the path mode, and you can see here is the auto. We will have to change this. I'll click on it and I'm selecting copy. Then I will click on this button, which is on the side, Amber Textures. I clicked on it. And now I can click the button, Export FBX to export my file. So the process is going. Okay, now we can go to the game. And in the game, on the right side, I will click on the button Load Objects from the Disk. Here, in the top, I will click again on the button Load Objects from the Disk. I will go to the Objects folder, and as you can see, here is my telephone, which we just have saved. So I'm clicking on it, and click the button Open, and the process of loading is going. So I will wait for the process to complete. This is done. I click the button down to close the window. Now here, click on the button Loaded Objects, and into the list you will see here in the drop-down menu, you will see the objects which you have loaded. In my case, there is only one telephone, I'm click the button to activate it, and as you can see, our telephone has appeared here. So you can manage this exactly the same as you are managing other things into the game. So I can move it, I can rotate it, and so on. So basically, that's it. As you can see, very easy.